Calvin Kastein in the auditorium at Northern Adirondack Central School, beautiful downtown Ellenburg Corners. And as you can see, there's a whole lot of activity going on. They are preparing for a school musical, which will be coming up very, very shortly. So we thought we'd come down here and meet some of the cast members, the director, and find out what's going to be happening and when. So don't go away. That's coming right up here on viewer-supported hometown cable. Okay, we have, to start with, the director. And your name is Pat Kelleher, but you're not the famous football coach.
No, I'm not. I'm Pat Kelleher, just the regular guy here at NAC.
Regular guy. I seem to recall you being the guru of indoor soccer for a while.
Well, I did do that for a while. That was for a while, and you move on. You know, you can only do something for so long, I guess. And you have to go with new interests.
Hey, you're a student or a teacher here, Pat?
Well, thank you very much. Yeah. I am a teacher here for 29 years.
29 years.
Yes.
Where's the time gone? Huh?
I don't know. It feels like I just started.
Now, a musical at Northern Adirondack. How long has this been going on?
This is our fourth musical. We started a few years, well, 4 years ago.
3 years ago.
Yeah, well, whatever it was, yeah, 3 years ago. And so it's something we've always wanted to do, and the musical director, Penny Wise, has always wanted to do a musical and has talked to me and talked to me, knowing I'd been involved in them in the past. So we finally got the impetus and did Grease as our first show.
Okay. Grease, then what?
We did Grease, and then we did Cinderella, Roger and Hammerstein's Cinderella, and then we finished last year with Crazy for You, which is all Gershwin tunes.
Oh, okay. That was, that's not one I'm familiar with. Is it mainly tunes, or is it?
Yeah, it's a lot of songs and dance in that, a lot of tap dancing, and we had some help for tap dance, and it was one of our better shows, I think.
Let's see, I came to last spring, that was it the NAC Idol or something?
Yes, yeah.
You were doing a little dancing up there yourself, weren't you?
I don't think I was dancing, but yeah, we run an NAC Idol every year also, and that's through the music department and part of the health program we have here. They run that.
Okay, so what's this year's musical called?
This year's musical is Hello, Dolly.
Well, that's convenient that it's titled that.
There's the poster right
the poster
there, yes.
Right there. And the dates and times?
The dates are the 9th, 10th, and 11th of March, so it's coming right around the corner. And the times are, I believe, show times are 7 p.m. on Friday and Saturday, and 2 o'clock matinee on Sunday.
Okay, general students and... kids always want to be treated like adults, right? So they're being treated like adults here. They pay the same price as an adult.
They pay the same price as a senior.
Oh, okay.
And general admission is $10. Students, seniors are $8.
Okay, well, I'm a senior. Is that?
Absolutely. You get to come in for whatever you want.
Actually, I won't be an official senior until April, but I'm closing in.
That's close enough for us.
Okay, so how long have you been rehearsing?
We've been rehearsing since January. The first weekend in January, we start. We rehearse on Sundays for 4 hours, 12 to 4. And then starting this week, once we're back from vacation, we go every single night, usually till about 6, to refine everything and get all our dances and songs. And the orchestra comes in on this Sunday to rehearse with them.
Okay, where do you get your orchestra from?
The music department asks people from all around. There's a select group that go from musical to musical because they enjoy playing, enjoy the music, and we're lucky to have the people they get. So, okay.
Yeah, so they kind of roam around.
That's
the North
right.
Country.
Yeah. Yeah, it's good because they're very familiar with the music, and it takes them a fairly short amount of time to really get comfortable with each show.
Now you've got to make sure you get a certain amount, number of seats filled up here in order to break even, because this doing a musical like this isn't free, is it?
No, it's not. It's almost $3,000 just to get the rights to put it on, and we do you know, have a lot of other overhead with costumes and lumber and all those things. So, yeah, it takes a few seats to break even, and we hope that we get enough that we can have a little bit of a bumper for next year's, at least.
How have you done in the past?
We've done well the first 2 years. Last year, our biggest day is usually the Sunday matinee. We had a snowstorm, so we were way, way down on Sunday. So we just about broke even last year.
Yeah, that's the problem with weather-wise. You never know what you're going to get, and March is a notorious month for surprise snowstorms.
Yes, it is.
Sugar snow, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, what can you tell us that you think we ought to know before I start talking to some of the performers?
Again, the students do a great job at coming out and rehearsing and getting the whole program going, and you know, they're the ones who do this, and you want to come out and see some good talent and some people who just are out there enjoying themselves on stage and getting on the, you know, you should come out. It's a real good show. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. That's what it's all about, is getting the kids out here.
Assuming somebody out there might be interested in a ticket, how are they going to get one?
We sell them right at the door, and if they want to get them early, they can come to school and get them through our office. We haven't established yet enough outside venues to sell them around. We tried that, and it was hard to coordinate and things. We haven't, we sold out of tickets before, but never of seats.
Okay, whatever that means. You can bring in chairs if you have to.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Okay, so anything else, Pat, before I bring a...
I don't think so. We appreciate everything you do with all the work that you do. So it's nice to have you here, and it's nice to have you do what you do.
Yeah, well, it's tough to find time to squeeze something like this in, I imagine. Yeah. You've got sports schedules to worry about, and
absolutely
concerts, and
yeah, right now we're between sports seasons, so basketball just ended, baseball starts a week after our show is, well, the Wednesday after our show is over, and so we're kind of okay with that. With as far as the performances go, it's hard to get the that's why we rehearse on Sundays.
Well, let me tell you, I've watched the younger teams out here, and basketball teams, and they could still be playing years to come, so don't get too comfortable with this weekend.
That's what I'm afraid of. Yeah, let's see how far we go into state playoff.
Sectional states and then regionals.
Right. Yeah,
because you're lining up here the same weekend as regional basketball.
Yeah, we're awful close. I hate to say I wasn't too worried this year, but years to come.
He said that. Not
years to come. Years to come, we may be in trouble. Yeah, you're right.
Okay.
We're on that upward swing.
Let's hope so. Yeah.
You know, everything's in peaks and valleys, and we're just climbing out of a valley.
Yeah,
now,
I'm very, very impressed with the teams I've seen here. They're really looking good.
Yep.
All right, Pat, thank
you very much. Thank you very much. Good to see you.
Pat Kelleher, not the football coach, though. I never know who I'm going to talk to till they show up. What's your name?
My name's Derek Ebersol.
What?
Ebersol.
Ebersol, okay.
Sydney Vanderbogart.
Sydney Vanderbogart, okay. I could probably spell Ebersol, but I'm not sure about Vanderbogart. You got a role in this musical?
I'm playing Horace Vandergelder.
Who in the heck is that? Is he related to Vanderbogart?
He is not. No. He is the half-millionaire.
Half-millionaire.
Half-millionaire living in Yonkers, New York. Probably the richest man in Yonkers.
Okay, which is, what year was this musical taking place then?
1890.
So the richest man in Yonkers was $500,000 in 1890.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So.
And he's also single.
A singer. He's single, you said?
He's single.
Okay. And so are you one of the leads then?
I am one of the leads.
Okay. And how about you?
I play Mrs. Irene Malloy. I'm a hat shop owner in New York City, and I'm engaged to be married to Horace. And unfortunately, it doesn't work out, but...
Don't give the story away!
But so
maybe it'll work out, folks.
There's a happy ending. There's a happy ending. That's the end of it. There's a happy ending.
So just show up at the end, and you'll...
No, go do the whole thing.
How long will it be? Have you timed it yet?
About 2 hours.
Yeah, it should be somewhere around 2 hours.
Including
probably
an intermission?
Yeah, with intermission, around 2 hours. Lots of fun. Lots of music and dancing.
Can't go wrong there, huh?
You cannot go wrong.
This is the fourth one. Have you been in these?
I have been in one musical before and a lot of plays.
Okay.
Regular plays.
And what grade are you in?
I'm in 11th grade.
Okay. And you?
I'm a senior.
And have you been in any?
I have been in two prior musicals and quite a few regular drama club plays here.
Okay. So what's the biggest role? Is this your biggest role yet? Or?
I'd say so, yeah.
Are you excited?
Very excited, but nervous.
All right, you got all your lines down pat?
Pretty much, yeah.
Pretty much?
Pretty much.
We're doing this on the 28th of February, so they've got another 10 days to get rid of the pretty and make sure it's
yeah.
They're all there. How about in the past? Did you, or compared to the past, how far along do you think you are?
I think I'm doing fairly well, I would say. I've done better.
You've done better?
Yeah.
And what, are these numbers, do you sing solo?
I sing one solo in one song.
Anything we might be familiar with?
No, not at all.
Not at all?
Not at all.
Okay. Alright, and how about you?
I have one song by myself.
It's called a solo.
Yes.
And what, anything I might be familiar with?
Probably not.
Oh, I've seen Hello Dolly before, so maybe I'll recognize it.
Maybe.
Okay. Anything else? You guys selling tickets? People can buy tickets for you guys, I assume, if they want to?
Yeah.
Yeah, if they wanted to.
The family, friends, or see you, say, hey, mm-hmm. Give me a ticket. You'll take care of them, right?
I would do that.
All right. And you will too, right?
Yes.
Right. Anything else I should know before I get a couple more victims here?
Come see the show.
All right. Come see the show. When is it?
March 9th, 10th, and 11th.
I'm going to have to put a caption in.
7 p.m. on Friday and Saturday, 2 p.m. on
Yes.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much.
Right. Thank you.
Okay. Two of the stars of Hello Dolly. I'm going to tell Mr. Kelleher to make sure the people coming here aren't foot difference in height anymore. What's your name?
Ryan Pazer.
Ryan Pazer. And?
Shawnee Velasquez.
Shawnee Velasquez and Ryan Pazer. I see. I've seen you playing some basketball out there and some other things. And you have no volleyball. Anything else?
I play tennis.
Tennis? All right. That's coming up shortly. When's practice start?
I'm not sure. It's really soon.
Do you play any baseball or anything?
No.
Tennis?
No. I play spring basketball.
Spring basketball?
Mm-hmm.
Where?
AAU.
Oh, okay.
The team in Plattsburgh.
Okay. So you're ready for a little traveling. That's coming soon then, right? All right. You got a part in this musical or are you just coming out here to talk to me?
No, I'm Ambrose Kemper.
Ambrose Kemper?
Kemper.
All right. What does Ambrose Kemper do?
He tries to marry the Vandergelder's niece.
Tries to. Okay, don't tell us what happened to her. You're going to try to marry your niece. And how about you?
I am Vandergelder's niece. Oh. And my name is Ermengarde.
You could have tried to marry him.
Yeah. I'm going to watch out.
Okay, do you like him? Or what's? Can you tell us some things about it without giving it away here?
I do like him. It's just a struggle to try to get there to the marriage.
Okay, what grade are you in?
I'm in 11th grade.
11th grade? And
me too.
Also in 11th? Mm-hmm. Been in this before?
Yep.
What have you done in the past?
Last year I was in Crazy for You, and the year before that I was in Cinderella.
You played the part of Cinderella?
No, I was just part of the chorus in Cinderella, and then last year I was Custis, I think.
Yeah. You forget that. Your resume is so long, it's hard to keep track of everything, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so any solos, or do you sing at all?
I sing, just not solo.
Just not solo. How about you?
I also sing, but not solo.
Not solo? So it's when everybody's up there singing and dancing, you guys are up there doing.
Yeah.
Okay. So is it worth the $10 or $8 to come see this?
Absolutely.
Yes, it does. Yes, I do.
Okay. Right, anything else I should know? Well, I got you guys out here. It's your opportunity here to talk to the world. This will be on the internet, available around the world, you know.
I'll just say, come to the show. It's going
to
be good.
Mm-hmm. And when is that show?
March 9th, 10th, and 11th.
That's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. 7 p.m. on Saturday, on Friday and Saturday, and
2
p.m. on Sunday.
Close.
But you know your lines, right?
Yeah.
You don't know what the musical is, but you know your lines. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Yep. All right, two more from Hello Dolly at Northern Adirondack. Okay, we have two more, and your names?
Minnie Faye. In the play.
In the play, in real life?
Ariel.
Fillion.
Ariel Fillion, and?
Nolan Ferguson, and I play Barnaby Tucker in the play.
Barnaby Tucker in the play, but Nolan Ferguson in every other day.
Yes, that's me.
Alright, you're the reigning old champion of Altona's Got Talent?
Yes, I am. This year,
did you put that on your resume when you applied for a position here?
I like to think so. I mean,
oh, did you say that? You realize who I am?
I did. I wrote something down. Something about that.
Of course, your father took all the credit, though. You realize that?
Yeah. Did a good job. So hopefully next year it'll be the same thing.
And when I think of filling all around here, I think of a diner in Cherubusco. Actually, on Route 11. Are you?
Our cousins own that.
Cousins own that.
Yeah.
How's the food there?
It's pretty good.
Pretty good? What grade are you in?
I'm a senior. I'm 12th grade.
12th grade. I knew what senior means. I've been around. And you?
I'm a junior.
In 11th grade?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. All right. And you've been in these before?
Yes, this is my third play.
Third one. What are you doing this time?
I'm an apprentice to Mrs. Malloy in the hat shop.
Okay.
I like follow her around and help her out.
You get in the way sometimes?
Sometimes.
And how about you?
I'm just a confused clerk's assistant, 17-year-old male. I'm pretty much just confused and after a bunch of women, but once I get there, I don't really know what's going on.
Well, you're only 17.
Yeah, I know.
Like
I'm only 17.
Life,
yeah.
Not like in real life where you're a mature adult. But
yeah.
So is it tough playing a 17-year-old?
Not at all.
Not really?
Comes naturally.
And how old are you in the musical?
I have to be a little bit more goofier than I am in real life.
How old are you, though?
I'm 17.
In the musical?
Around 17.
Around 17?
Yeah.
Oh, so
we're contrasting characters.
Yeah.
Is he chasing you?
Yeah, pretty much.
We end up together.
Yeah.
It's like a dog chasing the car. Chasing the car. Well, what do I do?
That's pretty much what it is. It's the best.
All right. You guys do some singing and dancing with the group?
Yeah, we have a few songs together.
Mm-hmm. Together?
Yes.
What?
There's four of us.
Yes.
That's a quartet?
Quartet, yes.
So you didn't think I knew that.
So.
But you're the better half of the quartet, you two?
I like to think so.
You kind of carry the quartet?
Oh, yeah.
All right, I'm asking everybody, y'all peeking, when's the musical?
It's
March 9th, 10th, and 11th.
What time?
7 and 7 and 2.
Yeah.
All right. Want to tell people? Tell people to come.
We won't let them. Yeah. We won't let them know.
It's gonna be our best one yet.
Best one yet. There you go.
Alrighty.
All right. Come to NAC. Thanks, guys.
Okay, we've got three people this time. Your name?
Hunter Favreau.
Hunter Favreau.
Danny Hoff.
Danny Hoff and
Dylan Almodovar.
Dylan Almodovar, right?
Yeah.
That's one of those names I have trouble pronouncing when I'm out doing a ball game and I see that Almodovar. Is there some Almodovars that have played ball right here?
What?
There's been some Almodovars that have played ball here.
Yes, there has
been. Because I have to pronounce all those names. Sometimes I struggle. You ever struggle with a name?
Sometimes.
Not your own, I hope.
Sometimes. That's the name I have the most trouble with.
Okay, who are you in the musical?
I am Rudolf Van Weisenberger.
Are you a Weisenberger in real life?
Yeah.
What's a Rudolf Van Weisenberger do?
I am head waiter of Harmonia Gardens.
Is that not? That's quite a prestigious job.
Yes, it is.
And what's so important about those gardens? Is that where Dolly sings, or...?
It's the most prestigious and fast restaurant in all of New York City.
And fast restaurant?
Yeah, we
faster
got some...
Faster than McDonald's?
Faster. We've got
more
some
prestigious
fast...
prestigious than McDonald's?
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit. Okay. Alright, I'm not gonna argue with you. I've never been to your restaurant. I've been to McDonald's, and they're hard to top, so I don't know.
Yep.
Alright, and you're... What do you do?
I'm a waiter.
You work for him?
Yes, I do.
You have my sympathies. Is he hard to work for?
No, I like him.
You like him?
Thanks.
Sure. After he leaves, you can tell us.
It's a good job.
It's a good job? He takes good care of his people, does he?
Very good care.
Okay. What about you?
I'm a waiter, too.
You're a waiter, too? You like your boss?
Yeah. I love him. I don't like him. If only they had a love button on Facebook.
There's no Facebook in 1890, so there.
Well, there is now.
Sorry, not in 1890. All right, so you've been in these before?
Yes, I was in it last year.
And what'd you do?
I was a cowboy.
That's a lot of fun. What was it? Was it?
Crazy for You.
Oh, that's right. It was just a bunch of songs and stuff.
Yep.
You been in it before?
No, this is my first year.
What grade are you in?
Ninth.
Right, you?
I am in 11th grade.
11th grader and?
I'm in 9th and I haven't done this. This is my first year.
I'm not starting.
Oh, well, my bad.
Have you done this before?
No, I haven't.
You're
going to
wait till I don't have any questions to ask if you answer them.
I'm sorry.
I'll ask them. You got to have some sympathy for my end there.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Right, you think you might do it again next year?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. Definitely. It's very fun.
And you'll be a senior next year. And
probably.
Probably. Probably be a senior or probably...
Hopefully, probably be both.
Okay. All right. Have there been any talk about what might happen next year with musical?
Not of my
knowledge. This one first.
Yeah.
Then.
Yeah. So right. Come watch this one.
All right. You guys do some singing with the troops out there?
Yeah.
Waiters, singing waiters?
Sing a lot.
Yeah.
You got a solo, though, or no?
No.
No.
I'm not that good of a singer.
Not that good of a singer. Yeah. But when you sing with the group,
It sounds
nice.
They
carry you.
Very nice.
Lots of dances.
Yeah.
A lot of dancing.
That tough to learn, the dances? That'd be tough.
Kind of.
I got lucky this year. I didn't have to do a lot of dancing. So I'm happy. I have zero rhythm.
How about the regular rank and file waiters?
There's a lot of dancing.
Yeah, I think it's fun, though.
Yeah, so. It's fun to dance.
All right, I've asked every other group. When is it?
March 9th, 10th, and 11th.
Yep.
All right. That's a Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, 7, 7, and 2, right?
Yes. Yep.
All right. Anything else you guys want to say? Ask you?
Just come see the show.
Yeah.
Support the NAC musical.
All right.
Theater group.
Good. Agreed with them, too.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, don't go away. We've got more. Okay, we have two more folk. Your name?
Megan Brunel.
Brunel?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Alyssa Baker Berto.
Oh, that's good. Two last names. You only got one.
Yeah.
And when she gets married, she'll have four last names.
Yeah.
And you'll only have one.
Yeah.
What are you doing in this?
I'm a part of the chorus, like a singer slash dancer.
Slash dance.
Yes.
Slash dance.
I don't know. We just like dance around and stuff. Oh. Like.
Singer and dancer.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
Not a slash dancer.
No, it's a slash dancer.
You a slash dancer?
Yeah, I'm a slash dancer with her.
You're in the chorus also?
Yes.
Are you in the school chorus?
No.
No.
Yeah, I'm in the senior chorus and select chorus.
Uh-huh. So you kind of carry people like her that...
Yeah, we pick up the slackers.
I can't sing very well, so...
She's lying. She does well.
Does she? You're just too modest.
Yeah.
That's your problem? You're just too modest?
Of course, yeah.
Okay, you're a senior?
Mm-hmm.
You're in a senior chorus, but it doesn't necessarily mean you're a senior, though, does it?
Nope.
Okay. But you're already a senior?
Yes.
Have you been in these before?
Yep, I was in last year with Crazy For You.
Okay, and that was the first one?
Yep.
You wish you'd gotten in as a...
Yeah, I definitely wish I would have gotten in them sooner.
Okay. How about grade you in?
I'm in 10th. This is my first year doing the musical.
Yeah, and you plan to keep coming back?
Yeah. It's fun, so.
Yeah. Rehearsals are long, though.
Yeah, they're pretty tough, but.
At this time of the year, you gotta rehearse, you gotta do homework. You do your homework, dude?
Yeah, I do my homework. Yeah.
How about you? You do your homework?
Mostly.
But it doesn't interfere with your performance. Right?
Of course not.
You gotta have priorities. Take care of them. The musical, then worry about the homework.
Yeah.
Right? Because, you know, after the 8th, 9th, and 10th, or 7th, what is it? I've forgotten already here.
9th, 10th, 11th.
9th, 10th, and 11th, you can do your homework then, catch up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, anything else I should ask you, ladies?
No.
You're just okay? You don't have any solos, you're just.
Nope, we're just in the chorus.
Just in the chorus. I mean, that's important. How many people are in the musical altogether, do you know?
A lot more than any year they've had so far.
30,
it keeps
40,
getting better.
I think 30 around,
yeah,
right?
30 plus, probably.
Wow,
yeah.
That's good. Huh? Did anybody cut?
I don't think anybody was cut. I think they mostly placed...
Found a place for everybody.
Because
they were cut. I wanted names if they were cut.
Nobody was cut, so.
Okay. Darn.
We found a place for everyone.
All right. Anything else, ladies?
No.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah. You're welcome.
Have a good day.
Yeah. They may never talk to me again. All right, we've got two folks in a musical and a Harlem Globetrotter here. So we've got three people here. Your name?
Colby Guerin.
Colby Guerin. And?
Anna Lajoy.
Anna Lajoy and?
Taylor Pitts.
Pitts or Pitts?
Pitts.
Pitts?
Yes.
Well, you must have to respond to a lot of people.
Yeah. They make fun of me.
Yeah, well.
But, hey.
Somewhere Castine probably has a meaning that I probably don't want to know about. So what are you doing in it?
I am a singer, dancer, chorus person.
Singer, dancer, mm-hmm. chorus, all around.
All around.
All around, all right. I know you two guys play sports. You play any sports right now?
Volleyball.
Volleyball, that's
yes.
a sport.
Yes, and tennis.
Tennis, that's yes. another sport, see?
And depends if you're a cheerleading fan or not.
You've got a cheerleading yes. competition shirt on.
Yes.
I was there.
Yes, so cheerleading.
Cheerleading, yes. Well, it's only a couple times a year it's a sport when you actually compete, otherwise it's still an athletic event, but not a sport during the season mm-hmm. because you're not competing.
Right.
But a couple times a year, are you going to any regionals or anything? Or are you
We're done.
Done? Okay. And you'll smile there. Look at her frowning. What? Oh, you play some basketball?
Yeah, basketball, soccer, and softball.
DSS, we call that. That's your grade you're in?
Ninth.
Ninth grade? And you?
Ninth.
You have to speak up here. I got noise in the back of me here. They're doing a lot of construction here at NAC, and there's noises in the background. All right, ninth grade, and?
I'm a junior.
A junior, and I know you play basketball, soccer, baseball.
Yep.
That's BBS, not that's BSS.
That's correct.
That's right. All right, you been in these before?
Yes, this is my third year that I've been in NAC musicals.
And what's your role this year?
I am one of the waiters in the Act 2.
In Act 2?
Act 2.
In that one act? Or do you play another, you're out there singing and dancing?
Yes, I'm also in the chorus for Act 1.
Okay. And you?
I'm just a singer / dancer / chorus person.
So how often are you out there?
A lot.
A lot?
Yeah.
And you too?
Yeah, a lot.
Interchangeable, you two, as far as your roles?
No, we go out there at the same time. All the time.
You what?
We go out there at the same time.
Yeah.
All the time.
Do you have any lines? Do you have any lines? Mm-hmm. So you just...
Background.
Do they tell you, you're going to be in this spot, you're going to be in that spot? So if you went out in that spot, she went out in that spot, it'd mess you all
yep.
up?
Yep. Very
think,
much.
Do you think that's true?
Yeah.
Good? Okay.
You just gotta play it off like it didn't happen, though, so...
How close to being ready are you?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not an answer. How
yes.
close?
Oh,
very
I'd
close?
Say, yeah, pretty close.
Very close.
Yeah.
All right. You think you're close?
Pretty much. Almost there.
Now, I know sometimes when people are up there dancing, somebody's watching somebody else to make sure that they're keeping step with them. Is there somebody that's a...
Yeah, but sometimes you just screw up anyways. I've tried.
You just hope people aren't watching you
yeah.
to keep up with you.
Yeah.
And if you mess up,
yeah.
then it's going to be a big disaster. Do you watch anybody?
There's a lot of people that go around me because there's a lot of movement going on, so I can't exactly watch one person. But I kind of watch a lot of people that go around me and just hope that they're doing it right.
Any big collisions yet, Colby?
No, actually there hasn't been any collisions. Thank God.
Yeah. You're saving those for the actual.
It was
musical.
Supposed to happen.
Yeah, we meant to do that.
Yep.
All right, you guys know when this is all going to take place?
March 9th.
March
10th.
And 11th.
Let's check.
Yes, you're right.
yeah,
Friday, Saturday, Sunday, March 9th, 10th, and 11th. right here in beautiful downtown Ellenburg Corners, right?
That's correct.
All right, and 7, 7, and 2, but don't show up at 7 because you'll...
You won't have a seat.
Yeah, nope. Well, it'll be close, it may not be a seat, so if you get here early. And if folks, family and friends want a ticket, they can contact you guys, right?
That's yeah. correct.
Anything else I should know that I've been alert enough to answer? Ask? Can you answer?
No.
You glad you came out here and talked to me?
Yes.
Say yes.
Yes.
Okay. Say yes.
Yes.
All right. Thank you.
That was unsolicited. Thank you. Do you know you have some paint on your shins?
Yeah.
When I arrived, she was one of the people painting the...
Yeah, a lot of work.
Her name?
Stephanie Snide.
Stephanie Snide and?
Olivia Barnaby.
Olivia Barnaby. I think I've mentioned both of your names in different sports over the past year or so, right?
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. All right. And you're what grade?
10th.
10th grade?
Yep.
And?
9th.
9th grade. You call her ma'am or...
No.
You look part. Are you in this musical?
I'm a stage crew.
Stage crew, so yep. You're behind the scenes.
Yep.
Wow, that's a lot of dedication because the people on the stage get all the glory and you do all the work.
Yeah, get a little bit of it.
Are you on stage or behind the stage?
I'm student director this year.
Student director?
Yep.
Oh my gosh.
Yes. I'm a student director for the play this year too. So.
So how come? How do you get a prestigious job like that?
I don't know. I guess I just know the right teachers.
Oh.
I did backstage for a couple years before, so I've moved on to directing.
Directing. Okay. What does a student director do?
Pretty
tell,
much.
Tell her to paint the stage?
Yeah. I just do whatever Mr. Kelleher says. I do anything that needs to be done, basically.
Is maybe it's student gopher. Give you a title.
Yeah.
Boy, have I got a job for you. You get your name up there in big lights. And
yeah.
So you're constantly on the go then, right?
Yeah. Yep.
And that's a big commitment too for you. You know,
yeah.
You're not on the stage at all. I mean,
nope.
You guys, so.
Nope.
Do they let you come out at the end and take a bow with the...
Yes. Yep.
Yeah. They'll at least let you do that.
Yeah. For the play, they called all the directors out and gave us like flowers and everything. So It was really nice.
That's a hint for this year, folks.
We're expecting flowers.
Okay. So you've been here. You gotta be here every night.
Yep. Yep.
So what have you done tonight as student director?
I've been helping Stephanie paint. We painted the whole runway, and mm-hmm. we're painting the stairs, and just take notes, and I filled in for somebody who wasn't there yesterday, so I just...
Do we give you a little paper there that says what you're supposed to say, or are you just supposed to answer?
Yep, I have my own script. I have a binder with everything that Mr. Kelleher has, and plus what all the other teachers have, so it's a lot.
Are there understudies in this?
No.
Somebody breaks a leg and...
No.
That happened many years ago in Shazy. A kid came out the next day, he broke his leg. I think it was, I don't know if it was the last show or whatever. They were doing Oliver.
For the play, we had to bring people in the week of the show, so they just pretty much freestyled and had a script on stage and everything, but we pulled it off and it went well.
Okay. What have you done besides paint?
Nothing really. We just painted.
Just that one. Yeah. You're doing a lot of bending over there and groaning.
Yeah.
You're not done yet. I see that the corner there is not completed yet.
No, we ran out of paint.
Oh. Plan ahead. Maybe you put it on too thick. If that might be it.
Probably. There's only a little bit left in the can anyway, so.
Okay.
This dance
what happens? You got there's like an apron out there to go around the where the band is, or the orchestra, excuse me. Is that going to be used again in future years? I mean, painting it up. Is there a place to store that stuff?
That was donated to us, actually. So right now, when the show's over, they're planning on taking it down.
But,
Yeah, no, they won't be left there, but it could be stored.
Maybe, yeah. This is the first year that we've used a runway, so we could possibly...
It's probably used in the musicals. Dolly come out there and sing? Or?
Yep, all the cast members
all
use
the,
it.
Oh, they, oh, wow. So they'll be walking around the orchestra then?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, so have you done this before?
No, it's my first time.
You gonna think about it in the future?
Yeah, I'll probably do it more.
Yeah, so it's a lot, like I said, it's a lot of work, a lot of commitment.
It's fun.
No lines to learn, too.
No, that's a good thing.
Do you sing along with some of the songs you might know while you're
no.
backstage?
No? No, I'm a bad singer.
How about you?
I definitely do.
You do?
Yeah. I sing it all the time.
Audibly?
No, not really.
Just to yourself, right?
Yeah. She sings to me.
Oh. When she gives you orders, she sings to you?
Yeah.
Go, go paint the apron.
Yeah.
Anything else, ladies?
No, I think that's about it.
I want to keep up the tradition of asking when this musical is.
2 weekends.
March 9th, 10th, and 11th.
Yeah.
Yes, you got it. 9th, 10th,
and
11th. Yeah. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Oh.
In the Norman Cavanaugh Gymnasium, auditorium, too. I should mention that.
Yeah.
Remember Mr. Cavanaugh. And tickets are $8 for students and seniors. And
$10 general admission.
General admission. How old do you have to be a senior?
65, I think.
You think?
I think so.
You check your IDs?
Oh, like senior, senior citizen
no.
or senior in school?
Senior citizen.
Oh.
You thought students would be included with seniors?
Whoops.
Oops. All right. Thank you, ladies.
Thank
unless
you.
Thank you.
Say.
No,
I'm right. good.
See
that's
you
good.
In the ball fields.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. Okay, we've just learned a valuable lesson off camera. Never run in a hall with socks on, right?
That's right.
Your name?
Leah Garceau.
Garceau?
Garceau.
And?
Sierra LeClaire.
Sierra LeClaire. Okay, LeClaire and Garceau. Very familiar names in the North Country, I would think.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Okay, and what are you doing in this?
I'm a singer, dancer, and for one part, I'm a waiter.
A waiter?
Waiter.
Oh.
I'm gonna be a man. I'm gonna be a man.
You can't be a waitress, you gotta be a waiter.
Gotta be a waiter. There weren't waitresses then.
Okay. So you're a singer, dancer, slash waiter. And you?
Singer, dancer, slash waiter.
You're also a waiter?
Yep.
What are you gonna do with that hair?
I don't know. Put it up, I think.
Chop it off.
Think,
let's just chop
I think
it
the
off.
Night before, you gotta cut it.
Oh, that's embarrassing. I don't think that'll look too good.
Hey, show must go on.
I'll have to buy a cap or something to put on a swimming cap.
That's wig.
Skin color.
Yeah.
Wigs are coming in again, so we're good.
All right, what grade are you in?
11th.
11th?
Yeah.
It took you a while to think of that.
I know. I always go to say 10th, but that was last year.
That was so
yeah.
last year, yeah.
So
yeah.
last year.
And you?
12th.
12th.
12th. I know. It's a nervous thing.
Were you in 11th last year?
Yes.
Right. Have you been in these before?
No.
No?
No.
You wish you had been?
Yes. Very much.
You want to tell all the younger kids out there watching to not wait till their senior year?
It definitely stinks waiting until your senior year because you realize that you like it and then you don't have a chance to do it again.
Right. And if you come out, find out you don't like it, well, then you don't.
Then you don't have to do it again.
And how about you, Amanda?
Oh, this is my first year.
First year?
Yeah.
Coming back next year?
Oh, definitely. Uh-huh. Before I was always stage fright and nervous, but then friends are like, it's fun, you should do it. So I tried, and now I regret not doing it before.
I have no more stage fright?
No, definitely not.
680 people out here in the...
And the fun, it's so fun, it's worth it. I can get past my fright.
Now you're moving on. I'm going to go check that camera. Don't go away. I want to check that camera here.
Sometimes people move, and they move right out of the picture, and all of a sudden I'm talking...
I hear the voice in the background.
Creepy voice.
Okay, anything else I should ask you guys about that you want to tell the folks?
I don't know.
I know you both know when the musical is, right?
Yes.
What's the name of it, first of all?
Hello, Dolly.
Hi, what's the name of the musical? Hello, Dolly. I just saying,
oh.
If you said Hello, Dolly to me, that's all.
It's a joke, Sierra.
It was a weak joke. And the dates are?
The March 9th, 10th, and 11th.
And the times are?
Friday on the 9th is at 6, and same thing on Saturday, but on Sunday.
Seven.
6 Central Time. 7 o'clock Eastern Time. 6 Central.
See, 7, yeah. 7.
Now, if you're watching this in Chicago, it says 6 o'clock. If you're watching this
here,
in and around,
it's at 7. And 2 o'clock on Sunday.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Good luck.
Thank you.
All
right. Thank you, ladies.
Now we have 3 more. Your name?
I'm Cody Weldon.
Cody Weldon and?
Lacey Jaguar
and?
Kristen Amadover.
I think I talked to a fellow named Amadover.
It's my brother.
Figured that.
Yeah.
What grade was he in? Was he 11th grader? I don't remember.
Ninth grader.
So you're what, 11th?
I'm a senior.
That's close to 12, I think, right? You been in these before?
Yep, this is my third year.
Third year? Coming back? 3 out of 4?
Yeah.
And what have you done in the past?
Well, last year I was backup, and the following year I was too, but then, what was the one after Greece? Cinderella. I was in the pit band.
Okay. And what are you this year?
A dancer.
Singer-dancer or just dancer?
Singer-dancer.
Lip-synchro-dancer.
No, I really sing.
You really sing? Okay. A lot of dancing?
Yeah.
A lot of dancing. What's the story about, anyway?
It's about a woman that meddles with other people's love lives, actually falls in love with one of the people she's meddling in.
Oh, is she a matchmaker type of person?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. She ends up getting burnt, huh? Or smitten. Smitten, you like that word? No, it's good. I can tell you, doesn't you like that word, smitten?
Sure. I like the word.
Yeah, it's a nice word. Not a word you hear every day, but you know. What are you doing in this?
I'm a background dancer and singer.
Background dancer and singer?
Yep.
Have you done this before?
No, this is my first year, actually.
And you're what grade?
I'm in 11th.
You wish you'd come out in the previous years?
So. Yeah, I do, because it's a lot of fun.
So you might be back next year, then?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you? Passed that already?
No, I graduated this year.
Well, you might come back anyway. As an older, mature advisor.
It's definitely a lot of work, but a lot of fun. So it's worth being in.
Keep up on your homework, this last couple of weeks when you've got to cram. And,
yeah.
And there's no looping around here, I noticed, when you're not on stage. Everybody's so serious. And,
yeah. We try to be.
Yeah, we try.
And you?
I'm a background dancer and singer also, but I'm also the court clerk, and I'm one of the waiters.
Court clerk, waiter?
And part of the chorus.
My goodness. What'd you do, try out for four parts here?
No, I'm actually I'm one of the people he just throws in.
Does a court clerk do anything besides...
I have one line, I think, in that.
And the waiter? Are you singing
dance
for the waiters?
Yeah, a lot of dancing with that.
Okay. You're out there a lot?
Yeah, nice. Just about every scene.
How about you, ladies? You out there a lot?
Yeah, we do the waiter scene also, and we're in the second act, we're in there a lot. So.
Yeah, we're on stage a lot. A lot of dancing.
You have to have costumes, girl, especially,
We have to wear dresses and hoop skirts.
You can... Is it your own clothes you're wearing, and dresses, or is
some of them are. Like, some of them they made, and, I brought some in for me.
Yeah.
You got a lot of 1890s stuff hanging around.
Yeah, because I wanted to do Marie Antoinette for Halloween, but I never did, so I had the dress, and it worked.
Marie Antoinette lost her head, so you don't...
Yeah.
But you just like saying, let him eat cake.
Pretty much.
Okay. Anything I should ask you guys?
Not really, and this is actually my fourth year. I've been all
I didn't ask you that.
So.
See that?
Yeah.
Fourth year, okay. Yeah. So you've done them all?
Yeah, I have done them all.
And you're what grade, you said?
I'm a senior.
Senior, so you're done.
I've done everything from backstage crew to on stage, so. Been quite interesting the last 4 years.
Yeah, you kind of look forward to this every year, I imagine.
Yeah, I do.
It's going to be sad leaving.
Yeah.
Like not being able to do this next year.
Well, if you're in the area, you're going to come watch next year's crew?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Cheer her on. She's gonna be up there.
My best friend.
Yeah, I will. I will definitely be back.
I'll be back. Arnold said that, you know.
Did you say it like Arnold?
I'll be back.
Sounds just like him. When is this musical?
The 9th, 10th, and 11th of March. At 7.
She's taking a sneak peek there.
I just realized it was there.
Times?
7, 7, and 2.
Very good. You guys concur?
Yes. Okay. Where are you going with it?
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yep. Okay. Ooh. Hello, Dolly at Northern Adirondack. Okay, we've got two more guys. I've talked to a whole lot of ladies so far, girls, and I haven't met Dolly yet. Who in the heck is Dolly?
Have
you decided yet?
I think.
I guess I asked the wrong people who Dolly is here. Is it a student?
Kayla Spear.
Oh, yeah.
Are you guys in the musical, or you just happened to wander by here and saw
no.
the camera?
No,
we're
stage crew.
Stage crew, yeah. Okay. All right, you didn't paint the apron there. I saw the ladies who did there. How come you guys weren't helping to paint the apron?
Well, we just got here from CV Tech.
Oh, I see. That's your excuse. You know,
yeah.
You stick with it, right?
Yeah.
Your name?
I'm Josh Dragon.
Josh Dragon?
Yep.
1-0 Dragon? Or 2-0 Dragon?
Just 1-0.
Just 1-0. And?
Philip Boyer.
Boyer? B-O-Y-E-A?
Yep.
All right. And what grade you in?
Both seniors.
Ask him that. Have you done this before? Helped out backstage before?
First time.
First time? How about him? Since you.
It's my first time too.
Okay. Well, that's about time, I'd say, right?
Yeah. I had a friend who tried to get me to join because they needed help, so I figured I'd join.
Hey, yeah. You guys are learning a trade there at CB Tech. You might as well put it to use back here, right?
Yep.
What are you guys taking up? What are you taking up?
I did carpentry last year and electrical, so I'm doing electrical design this year.
And you?
Graphic design.
Graphic design, huh? You're gonna work in that computer then? Alright. So you'll design his the houses you'll build? Maybe. Okay. Does your graphic designing come in at all here? You don't
probably not.
Here? No. What have you had to do so far backstage?
Pretty much we've worked on moving the sets, like during which scenes we put them on and stuff. Yeah.
This is both your first time doing it, right?
Yep. Yeah.
So between acts, you guys got to know exactly.
Yeah, we got to learn all the cues and stuff when to bring out the sets.
And what to bring out and,
yeah.
And how to not make noise. And
yep, exactly.
Are you good at not making noise?
Yeah, I'm pretty good.
Oh, yeah. How about you?
Yeah, pretty good.
Pretty good at not making noise. Oh, well, looks like the ladies are back. Somebody went and got some paint there. They told me they were out of paint, so they couldn't finish that apron. Now somebody must have went and gotten some more. Must have gone to Dominic's and picked up some paint. Looks like Mr. Kelleher is teaching them a few dance steps up there.
Yeah, they're finishing their act, I think act two. They needed a little bit more work, and they're getting it through now, so.
So, on these rehearsal nights, are you able to do your homework and that kind of stuff, or your attention got to be?
We got to pay attention a lot because we got to know when to bring out the sets and stuff. So.
He doesn't need to be telling you every time.
Well, at first he tells us when to bring them out, and then we have to make posters. We're gonna make these posters that tells us when to get ready for the sets and when to bring them out.
We're
so
ready, but okay. It's time. Yeah.
How big a back crew stage is there? Big your crew backstage.
How would you say?
I'd say about six of us. Yeah, sounds right.
Okay. So you each have specific things that you do?
We're assigned to certain sets that we gotta bring out. So we have whatever set we're learning now, we stick with for the play, so we know exactly when to bring them out.
So at least there's no confusion.
Right. You know what you're doing, and he knows what he's doing, and that way you're not waiting for somebody to do what somebody else should be doing. Okay, anything else, guys, that I should know about?
No.
When is this musical, anyway? I know they won now.
8, 9, 10. 8?
Yeah, no, so. Close, but 9, 10th, 11th. Oh. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. 7, 7, and 2 right here at Northern Adirondack. You think people ought to come?
Yeah, I think it's going to be a great show. It looks to be, it's going to be like a funny kind of show too. So.
Is it starting to, as you watch different portions of the rehearsal, is it starting to fill in and what it's going to look like in your minds?
Yeah, they're getting a lot of it done. We actually did a run through a couple days ago, and it's looking like it's going to be a great show. Yeah.
So you kind of got to figure it out, because as they're rehearsing stuff, it isn't necessarily in the order that it's going to be on the stage, but now you guys have kind of seen that. All right, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
All right, thank you. Two more of those vitally important backstage folks. Okay, we have two more folk. Your name?
Jillian Scott.
Jillian Scott and?
Darby Rabideau.
Darby Rabideau. I think I've mentioned your games a couple times this year. Huh?
Yeah.
In ball games?
Yeah.
I have no other reason to mention your names than in ball games. what are you doing?
I'm stage crew.
Stage crew?
Yeah.
What grade are you in, Jillian?
I'm in 10th grade.
10th grade. Is it going to be a varsity team next year or JV?
I'm not sure. We still have a young team, but...
But you'll be an 11th grader?
Yeah, but I don't know. We're probably going to move people up to have a varsity.
I think you're hoping that way.
I don't know. I'd rather win games.
Yeah, it's fun winning. Would they allow you to play?
Yeah, I think so.
You think so?
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
You don't know. You'd hate to find out that they won't. Huh?
Yeah.
what do you think? Think you'll be a varsity next year?
I don't know. I guess it depends on the players.
Well, let's hope so.
Yeah.
It might be a learning experience for the young team. What grade are you in?
10th.
You're in 10th? So you're in that same situation then, right?
Yep.
All right. What are you doing in the musical?
Lights.
Lights? Yep. You're backstage too then?
Yeah.
So that's it. You do lights. That's a lot of timing and...
Yeah.
Is there somebody in your ear? Do they have somebody, the director or somebody saying, all right, Darby...
No, we have a lighting plan. It's like on a piece of paper, just when I need to do stuff.
Have you done this before?
I did it for the 12 Angry Jurors this fall, but that's it.
Did you mess up?
No. Hopefully, this is harder though for the musical, so... Hopefully I don't mess up.
You hit the wrong light at the right time, yeah. Or the wrong time, or whatever. And what specifically do you do backstage?
I'm mostly moving sets around.
Moving sets around because you have big muscles?
Yeah.
Okay, now you guys are here every night there's a rehearsal. You guys got to show up?
Yep.
So it keeps you guys busy.
Yeah.
Now, what would you have done if, of course, you're not... You didn't have to worry about it because you didn't have a varsity team, but if next year, if you guys are on the varsity and this weekend is the finals, next weekend's the regionals, what would happen if you guys kept on winning?
I probably wouldn't be able to do the play.
Say sorry.
Yeah.
Somebody else, you guys planning to come in and come back, Jonah? Help out next year?
Yeah. Yeah. I might try to actually be in the musical next year. I'm not sure.
There you go.
Yeah.
Casting. How about you, Dark?
I'm more of a backstage person.
Okay. So, but you think you might come out and help out again next year?
Yeah.
The timing on this is you just got done your basketball season. Were there any conflicts with your basketball in this?
I'm not a basketball player, but.
Oh, you didn't play basketball?
No.
Oh. Like Rabideau, you didn't play basketball? What's the matter with you? You played soccer, didn't you?
Yep, yeah. Soccer, softball.
Okay, I'm not a basketball player.
No.
Oh, you're a cheerleader? No? You take the winter off?
Yeah.
Oh. You ever tried basketball?
I did in 7th grade. Didn't really care for it.
Didn't like it?
No. Not in school. I like just playing around at home, but not in school. Competitively.
You come from a long line of basketball players?
Yes.
So you just kind of had to play basketball, right?
Yeah, it's kind of a requirement. I mean, if I didn't like it, I wouldn't have to play it, but it just runs in the family.
You're glad you like it, right?
Yeah.
All right, anything else I should ask you guys? I'm going to ask you, I've asked everybody else, when is this musical?
March, 5th, 6th, and 7th, or 6th,
7th? 9th, 10th, and 11th.
9th, 10th, and 11th.
7th, 7th, and 2. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Don't show up on the 5th, 6th, and 7th. You'll be early. You might catch a rehearsal, though, so that'll be fun. Okay, anything else, ladies? No? right, thank you very much for chatting
with me.
Thank you.
Okay, we have another folker. What's your name?
My name is Brent Shatnoff.
Spell that last, Shatnoff?
Shatnoff, C-H-A-T-E-A-U, N-E-U-F.
Shatnoff, yeah, got a French name, huh?
Yeah.
does that mean house, some kind of house?
Either House of Nine or Castle Nine, either or.
Okay.
It's not really a big difference, but it's all up to interpretation.
Well, you're looking for the castle part. Right?
Yeah.
So you're from the Ninth Castle family.
Yeah.
Alright, and what grade are you in?
I am a senior.
A senior. Have you partook in this before?
Yes, actually I was a stage crew last year. I did the curtains for the play Crazy for You.
Okay, what are you doing this year?
I'm doing curtains this year, and I'm also help directing the stage crew and partaking in other activities that have to do with moving around the set and getting things done like that.
A vital part of anything here, because obviously the people who are on stage can't be bothered moving stuff here and there, and
yeah,
and you got to know what to move and when to move it and where to put it. And are there markers on the floor?
We generally use markers in the form of black duct tape on the ground. That helps us, so it gets ready, and we also do rehearsal and timings to get ready for it, so we can have everything well performed on the night of the play.
And is the curtain closed most of the time when you're doing this, or sometimes you're doing it in the dark?
It varies. Most of the time the curtain will be open, but in different sections it could be partially opened or other curtains could be closed, but it all depends on which scene it's in.
If you're moving stuff in the dark, that's a bit of a challenge probably, especially to find that black marker on the floor.
Yeah, but the backstage lights are still on, so you can still see them a little bit, but it really requires a skill of depth perception. You've got to figure out particularly where it is, so that's why you practice and you memorize exactly where the pieces go. So the markers are just there for like guidelining.
Yeah, just as a reminder.
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else that I should know? You said this is your second time you've done it?
Yep.
And you're a senior, you said?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is it then, huh? No more.
Yep. Last play I'll probably be in, at least in high school. But I hope I'll be able to join a theatrical group in college, maybe, or something like that.
For college?
Got
one picked out yet?
Clinton Community for the first year or two, and then I'll probably transfer out to a college down south. Not sure which yet, though.
The warmer climate? Is that
what you
mean? Since you haven't got one picked out, I assume it's the climate you were looking for.
That, and it's where my profession I want to be in is usually located, in the southern states.
Okay. Whatever that profession might be?
That profession would be either marine biology or astrophysics.
Oh. Well, you better hit the books.
Yeah, exactly.
Those are worthy goals.
Yep.
Okay, well, thank you very much. I'm going to ask you, though, the name of the musical is?
The name of this musical is Hello, Dolly.
And what is it?
Its performances are on March 9th, 10th, and 11th.
7, 7, and 2.
Yep.
And where?
Here at NAC Auditorium in Ellenburg.
Norman V. Cavanaugh Auditorium.
Norman V. Cavanaugh Auditorium.
All right. Thank you very much.
All right,
thanks for chatting with me. Cool. All right. Norman Cavanaugh, of course, a longtime principal here. He was principal, high school principal, and we lost him a few years ago. And much like the Francis Bud Moore Auditorium at Northeastern Clinton. And Francis Bud Moore, ironically, is the father-in-law of the director, Pat Kelleher, here. So nice when they name a part of the school in memory of longtime people who served here. I don't know if we have any more coming. We'll find out together, I guess. Yes, we have some more folks to talk to, including Dolly.
Dolly Levi.
Dolly Levi.
Yes.
And who is Dolly Levi when she's not Dolly Levi?
Kayla Spear.
Kayla Spear and?
Erica Harriman.
Margaret Harriman. Alright, are you on the...
I'm Ernestina Money.
You're who?
Ernestina Money.
Ernestina Money.
Yes.
I love your last name.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's my real last name, but Dolly says it.
I made it up.
Oh, you made it up?
Yes, I did.
Aren't you the clever young lady?
Yes, I am.
So, you a friend of hers, or what?
No, I'm just a random character throughout the show. I'm like...
And she's making up names for you?
Yeah, or because...
Maybe you can make up a few names for her, too? How would you like that?
You know, she wants to. She's a pretty awesome name already, though, so...
Yeah. So, she calls you Ernestina Money, did you? You never had a name before that?
I was Ernestina.
Yeah. So what do you do?
I go on a date with Vandergelder.
Rich guy.
And he ends up leaving me halfway because I'm just too
artistic. Don't
tell
us too much.
Okay, I won't.
You're too artistic.
Yes.
What does that mean, too artistic? That sounds like an excuse.
It's not
you, it's me.
Yeah. It's a nice way of putting what I do throughout the show.
Artistic? What is artistic? What do you do?
She's a little saucy.
Yes.
She's got a bit of an attitude. And
well, show us that attitude right now.
Right now?
Right now, just a little bit of it.
I
don't want to scare the folks.
You
can't do it, huh?
I don't know, because... Sorry?
I think she'd give too much up.
Yeah, I would.
Oh, okay.
It would.
Good excuse.
Not to give too much.
And how about Dolly? You got an attitude. Talk about it.
I have a huge attitude.
You got a huge attitude. I hope you realize that. Yeah.
And I'm manipulative.
Uh-huh.
I just treat everyone like my little puppets.
Uh-huh. Well, it ain't gonna work with me, so forget about it, okay?
You don't want to be one of my puppets?
You watched any of the... filmed performances of Hello, Dolly?
I did. I watched the one with Barbara Streisand.
Oh.
Twice. Yes.
I haven't seen Carol Channing yet?
No, but we have the soundtrack to listen to, and it's Carol Channing. Yeah.
Can you sing like Carol?
Hello.
Carol Channing.
Yeah.
Oh, that was Channing?
Okay. Yeah, that was my impersonation of Channing.
Okay. So you make your own interpretation up there of this? How do you... do this, or are you supposed to emulate somebody else, or are you supposed to your version of Hello Dolly or whatever?
Well, it's the original, but I spice it up. I put a little Kayla into it.
I hope so.
Yeah,
it's gonna be a little bit individual here. How much singing does Dolly do besides Hello Dolly?
I have quite a few songs.
You know,
I sing, I think, three or four by myself, and then a couple with the chorus. And a couple with Mr. Vandergelder.
So you got a heavy workload then, huh?
Yes.
Isn't all fun and games up there, is it? Huh?
It's hard work, but it's worth it in the end.
Did I ask you what grade you're in?
12th.
Did I ask you what grade?
I'm a senior also.
I'm a senior also, okay. So, you've been in this before?
I was in the musical production last year of Crazy for You.
Uh-huh.
Yep, I was in a British Traveler.
Well, welcome to America.
Thank you.
You've come a long way. That's a line from Dolly. you knew that right away. Right?
Mm-hmm.
What have you done before?
I have been in every single production that we've done.
Every one of them.
For the musical. Four. I've done Grease and Cinderella and Crazy for You and now Hello Dolly.
Yep. That's your biggest role?
No.
No?
I was the fairy godmother in Cinderella.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
So you changed a lot of pumpkins then.
Yes.
Okay, you're going to miss this next year, I'll bet.
Oh, it's going to be horrible leaving. I'm going to be so sad.
And did you try out for Dolly? Did you say, oh, that's me?
Actually, I went into the audition saying that I would take whatever part they gave me.
Being humble.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just said, you know, I'd like a principal role, but I wouldn't mind whatever they gave me. You know, it was a huge shock when we went up to the casting list and my name was next to Dolly.
Said moi?
What?
intimidated you at all? That's such a, you know, a lot of lines. I mean, Dolly's...
There are a lot of lines and a lot of songs,
part
but...
Of this musical here, it's just... Obviously, it all evolves around you.
Yeah. But, it, like I said, it's
kind
worth
like
it.
Real world, right?
Oh, everything revolves around me.
Okay. Do you agree with that?
Everything revolves around her.
Always.
Always.
Okay, well, somebody gave me the name of Money. I think I'd agree with them too. So do you have a happy ending in this, or do you want to give it away?
I don't really think I have a happy ending.
You don't have a happy ending?
No.
Kind of lost in the,
yep,
in the ethers here.
I go back to being whatever I was before Dolly came. I just kind of float away.
They just kind of forget about
you. Yep.
Whatever happened to her.
Yeah.
Okay. When is this musical?
March 9th, 10th, and 11th. March 9th, it's at 7 p.m. Uh-huh. March 10th.
We're going to let her answer the,
yes,
the other two.
9th.
March 10th.
You've already said it. 10th and 11th.
What time?
Oh, the, it's 7 and then, I don't remember the, two. Okay.
You got to be here, you know.
Yeah, I know I have to be here.
It's important that you,
yes,
know when this is going on.
Yes, that is a good
up,
idea.
If you show up for a 7 o'clock performance on Sunday night.
Yeah, that might be just a little late.
Yeah.
Don't feel bad. The mail lady didn't know the times or the dates.
That's true. Okay, anything else, ladies, that I should know about?
No, just it's a fantastic show, and
yes,
everyone should come see it.
Everybody,
yes, everybody.
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 We got a crowded in here, though. Overflow crowd. You see the big headlines.
Even if you have to sit on each other's laps, it will definitely be worth it.
It will be.
A matchmaker like you, that's right up your
of
alley,
course,
getting people to sit in each other's laps. So yeah.
I'll make sure that the couples sit on each
you
other's
come
laps.
Out here and say, all right, you two get together.
You need to
two,
switch.
Yeah.
And you sit with him.
Yeah, yeah. There you go. All right. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you very much.
Right. Dolly herself and the Money Lady. I don't know who this guy is, but when he decided to come out here, two girls started chasing after him, so... What's your name?
Justin Kellett.
Justin Kellett. And?
Morgan Coons.
Coons and?
Courtney Smith.
Courtney Smith, okay. You the wrestler Kellett, or...?
Yeah, yeah. I'm the bigger one.
The bigger?
The bigger Kellett.
The bigger Kellett?
Yeah.
Did one of you guys go to the States?
I did.
Did you?
Yeah.
Talking to Keith Dahlbeck last night, got in publications.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned your name. Everybody said if it was good or bad. Oh, he said you had a tough draw, right? Yeah, the first.
Oh yeah, I got. Yeah.
You drew the number one or two, right?
Yeah, number one, right off.
That's a bummer, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, what are you doing in this musical?
I'm a dancer and a singer.
Are you a dancer and a singer all the time, or just in this musical?
Just in this musical. I had a couple parts a couple years ago, but.
What?
Couple parts different times, but we're switched around a lot of the time. He needs us where he needs us.
Oh, he's a very agreeable person, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. What grade you in?
I'm a senior.
A senior?
Yeah.
Yeah, you said that with authority here.
Oh, yeah. It's about time.
After 4 years of being a junior, it's about time you're a senior, right?
Yep.
Have you done this before?
Yes, yes, three other times.
You've been in all of them then.
Yes. I love it.
You won't be able to say that next year, though.
No, I'll just be doing them at Potsdam.
Oh, yeah. You've already signed up? They already know you're going to be there?
Yeah.
They said we can't wait till she gets here?
I don't know about that.
Potsdam State? Or?
Yeah, SUNY Potsdam.
Okay. And you?
I'm a waiter.
You're a waiter?
Yeah.
What are you waiting for?
This practice to be done.
Graduating.
I'm a junior.
A junior. Have you done these before?
No, it's my first year.
Will you be back?
Yes. Yes, I will.
You enjoy yourself?
Yeah, it's fun.
Singing and dancing waiter? And
yeah.
What kind of an outfit are they going to give you,
Something about an apron and...
Yeah, black pants.
Black pants,
black
pants and an apron.
Black pants
so.
And an apron. And a white shirt, maybe? Or?
Yeah.
And trays. We've got gold trays.
Yeah, nothing on them, I hope.
They're going to be using props on them, yeah.
Oh,
we have
be
to
glued on?
I think so.
So you can fool the audience and just kind of...
Yeah.
Be too dangerous.
Do that on Sunday. Do that before that, Mr. Keller might say. Don't come back.
Oh, gosh.
And you?
I'm a junior.
You're a junior, and what are you doing in this musical?
I'm in the chorus, and I play an old lady in one part.
An old lady?
Yep.
Kind of an old lady.
A mean one.
A mean old lady.
Yeah.
Something to
work on for the future, right? You start now, by the time you get old, you can be a real meanie.
Maybe.
So, you have lines as the mean old lady?
Or? Yeah, like two.
You have two lines?
Mm-hmm.
Well, just in case I don't make it to the musical, what are the lines? I know I've heard them.
It's a surprise.
Surprise lines.
Surprise lines.
Uh-oh. You use a mean old lady's voice?
I attempt to, but I'm not very good at it.
Let's hear what you got so far.
Do it.
It's not good.
Do it.
I don't...
You guys want to tell me, show me what she sounds like?
Oh, I don't know her part.
Well, she didn't just say, she didn't just say her part and be an old lady. Just
like, what? Well, well, Mrs. Lima.
Sound like a witch.
Oh, that's good.
Nobody's ever thanked me for saying that before, yeah? You sound like a real mean old lady.
Thank you.
So, you said what grade you're in, you said?
I'm a junior.
Junior. So, you've been in this before?
No, this is my first year.
You wish you'd come out before?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
You think you might come back next year, or?
Yeah.
Did I ask you that? You're coming back?
Yeah, I'm coming back.
I forget, I stopped at 46 people, you know? I don't remember what my name is.
Yeah.
It's not easy. Okay, alright, I've asked everybody else. When is this musical?
March 9th, 10th, and 11th.
You guys agree?
Yes.
Sure.
Be there. 7 o'clock on Friday, 7 o'clock on Saturday, and 2 o'clock on Sunday. Just ask her all the questions.
Yeah,
I've done this before.
But as I told the last crew, you guys have got to show up that day, so you better know when
it is. We usually stay after school, and we have this big get-together. It's like a family, and we eat dinner together, and we give inspirational speeches, yeah. They'll be a part of the family now.
Kind of like being on a football team, I reckon.
Yeah. It pumps us up, because you're kind of scared at first. Then you get on the stage, and you hear the applause, and you're like, oh, wow, I didn't expect that to happen.
Yeah. They're rehearsing right now, so they were some dancing and stuff.
Yeah.
Yep.
So if you guys mess up, you're going to say, we would have got that if that cast iron guy hadn't kept us talking.
Oh, we're lucky. Yeah. We're not in this one, thank
the
Lord.
Thank God.
No.
All right. Well, thank you very much. And anything else you want to say? Now's your time.
Come
to
the
show.
Be there, be square.
Go Bobcats.
All right. Thank you very much.
So this will wrap it up. There's Director Kelleher leading the parade. That's part of the musical, though. He doesn't normally tip around on one leg and wave a handkerchief. So I think if you've been watching this, you've probably got the gist of it. Hello, Dolly, at Northern Adirondack Central School. Come out and support the kids on the 9th, 10th, and 11th. 7 o'clock, 7 o'clock, and 2 o'clock are the three times. And hopefully we won't get a snowstorm that next weekend, and we'll be able to come here and enjoy. So that's it. Thanks for watching, and for those of you who understand what Hometown Cable is all about and support our continuing efforts to bring you what's happening in and around the North Country. Thanks for